right now.
Tonight, disturbing new details in the mass killing at the Azana Salon and Spa.
Brookfield police just released 600 pages, part of a big report including dash cam video and 911 calls from that day. Three people died, Zena Daniel, Carrie Roebuck, and Malin Lynn, at the hands of Zena's estranged husband. We have live team coverage of what led up to that day, the moments immediately following the shooting, and how Zena's family is trying to prevent this from happening again. We begin with Nick Bohr live in Brookfield. Nick, you've been pouring through those documents today.
And Craig, we knew that it had to be terrifying when Radcliffe Houghton burst into the Azana Salon and Spa a little over 4 months ago. But today, Brookfield police released those 617 pages of documents and the chilling 911 calls describing Houghton's rampage.
City of Brookfield police, man with a gun call, Azana Hair Salon, 200 North Moreland Road.
Police raced to Azana Spa October 21st as the 911 calls from people inside the spa rolled in.
We're at Azana Salon and Spa. Somebody's husband came in with a gun. We hear gunshots. We need someone to come here.
A terrified employee huddled in a closet, already shot. She whispered in her call.
I've been shot.
You've been shot, ma'am?
That gunman, Radcliffe Houghton, was on a rampage, shooting at will. His terrified stepdaughter ran across the street to Brookfield Square, fearing for her own life and that of her mother.
I was in Azana, Radcliffe Houghton. My stepfather came in. He tried to take my mom. He told everyone to get on the ground.
Do you know if anybody was hurt?
Yes, he shot Malin. He shot her, and I heard him shoot a lot of people.
She's speaking of Malin Lind, one of the three women killed. It's clear Zena's daughter knew her life was shattering.
I heard him shoot.
Okay.
He reloaded so many times.
Okay.
I saw so many shots, and I don't know who he all shot at. And I hope my mom's okay, because I just ran out.
Police believe the final shots Radcliffe fired were those that killed his wife, Zena. Among the mountain of evidence, a video showing Radcliffe Houghton at a Brown Deer sporting goods store just a day before the shooting. He's buying ammunition for a gun he bought the same day on the internet.
Of course, we now know that Houghton killed Zena and two others before taking his own life. The report also sheds more light on Radcliffe Houghton's behavior in the days leading up to the assault. Coming up on 12 News at 6, the threats he made and the chilling message he left behind inside their Brown Deer home for his teenage daughter. Reporting live in Brookfield, Nick Bohr, WISN 12 News.